What's up, guys? Welcome to another Battlefield Wednesday commentary, and this one is on Hill 137. If you just add like a 3 in between them, you get 1337, which I find pretty awkward. I don't know if they did that on purpose, but basically what this map is, it's pretty awesome, but you don't get to see really the awesome part. The awesome part is like the objectives after this one, after they capture A and B, which I believe in this gameplay they don't, because we don't allow them to. They move on to the next objective, which is in like this area that has been completely obliterated by napalm strikes and artillery strikes and everything like that. So it looks pretty goddamn awesome. And a quick tip for you guys who are new to this game: if you see those boats that come out and try to kill you, you'll notice that they have the driver and two gunners. The gunner on the front, he has like he's using this machine gun that has two like machine guns in one, so it's like he's firing two machine guns, and the gunner on the back only has one. But to take him out, just do what I did right there. You can see it. All you gotta do is just aim at the gunners and the drivers, and you could take them all out with one magazine from the AK-47, and they're all gone. It's really that easy. A lot of people, they get annoyed by those boats, but they don't really know that you can just take it out that easily. And I still believe the AK-47 is a tad bit overpowered, just like an incy wincy bit. I'm making up like words here and shit, but I think that they just need to give the vehicles a little bit more armor. And you can see how the other team has like nobody on it, but that doesn't mean that the fucking game is easy. I mean, these guys, they don't stop coming at you, and then people join in and everything like that. But anyways, I wanted to talk to you guys about this channel that I joined up with. It's Pawn Star for Hire. He started this channel. It's called Arc Gaming, and you guys can go check it out. The link is in the description box. Go subscribe to them, check them out. Check us out, because I'm part of it. It's basically like a PS3 team, all PS3 players and everything like that. And it's pretty cool. A lot of cool guys on there. Some of them I don't know, some of them I do. And there's gonna be some great stuff happening on that channel, so go check it out and subscribe to them immediately, or I'll chop your fucking balls off. No, that's kind of mean. I don't know, like, who in their right mind will chop a dude's balls off? I mean, that's just going a little too far. You know, there's like a certain line you don't cross, like the line of, it's like honor. You know, as soon as you fucking chop some dude's nuts off, that's not honorable right there. You can't do that. But I mean, if it's a life-threatening situation, yeah, go ahead, chop his balls off. I don't know how, you know, maybe if he's like one tough-ass motherfucker, he's gonna keep on charging at you, even with his balls chopped off. But I don't know. I don't know how I'm even talking about this. This is insane. We're talking about chopping off dude's balls, which is making my balls kind of hurt. But I got this new chair, and it's like, I don't know if you can hear that, but it sounds kind of, you know, homo. Sounds like I'm doing something really naughty, but it makes like this noise, and it's fucking annoying. Like, I don't know if all chairs like this do this, but it really is bothering me. Like, I don't want it to sound like somebody's humping my leg every time I move, and it's doing that. Like, come on, they shouldn't make chairs like this. This is not really good. I feel like I'm being molested or some shit. But oh, god damn it. You see, now I'm uncomfortable. Now I gotta move. Now, you see, now it sounds like something else now, you know what I'm saying? But, oh man, we're going from chopping off balls to an uncomfortable chair. But anyways, regarding that PS3 team, I do have some console-related news. Some of you guys know, a lot of you guys don't. I have an Xbox. Oh yeah. A lot of you guys have been waiting for this moment. You're like, finally an Xbox. Yeah, I bought an Xbox 360, the new slim version. I have it right here. I shouldn't really like touch it at all, because I heard like, I don't know, I heard rumors about if you like even look at it the wrong way, your disc gets scratched. Like, I don't know if the Xbox has feelings or whatnot, but I know you cannot move it while there's a disc inside and it's all on, so I'm definitely not gonna do that. I'm not even gonna look at it while playing my game. But it's right next to my PS3, and I really, now that I got the Xbox 360 Slim, I want the PS3 Slim, because my PS3 just looks really big compared to the Xbox 360, and I feel that that's kind of intimidating right there. But I'm glad that the Xbox 360 is it is the way that it is now, because before I heard like it was re like the old Xbox, it used to get extremely hot and it was like a heater and it was real loud and everything like that. But the new one, I gotta admit, it's not loud. It doesn't get overheating. It doesn't get overheated, and it's pretty good. And I enjoy it. I'm enjoying it. And my first impressions of Xbox Live, right on, man. That shit is awesome. This does not mean that my PS3 is just gonna be a dust collector. No, I still love my PS3, and I do feel that Battlefield is more of a PS3 game, and Call of Duty is more of an Xbox game. So that's my belief, because I guess I still haven't gotten fully used to the controls, but I still feel that way. And the one thing I do have to get used to, I'm holding the 360 controller right now, is the analog sticks. Not because of the fact that they're in different spots, but because of the fact that it's not like the PS3 analog sticks. For those of you guys who have PS3, the analog sticks like come outward. For the Xbox, it's like inward, if you know what I mean. It's like kind of like your thumb just goes all in it, and that sounded very perverted, but I gotta get used to that, because I don't know, it's like the grip is different. Like the way you grip it, and it feels different. I gotta get used to it. But overall, I am enjoying the Xbox. I don't have Call of Duty for it yet, but I will be getting it soon when I get paid. And it's great, I gotta admit. You know, they just shape it up, and I got my PS3 on one TV, my Xbox on the other, so it's pretty cool. I can play Xbox and watch a movie, or I can play PS3 and watch a movie, so it works kind of both ways. And I'm thinking about buying a third TV, and I know you guys are like, what the fuck is wrong with you? What you need three TVs for? But two TVs for a PC and one TV for whatever, or one TV for my PS3, one TV for my Xbox, and one TV for my PC. Now that's some crazy shit. That would be awesome. But yeah, anyways, I got an Xbox. My friends list is not going to be open to the public. I apologize. I know a lot of you guys were hoping that you'll be able to add me, but the reason why is because space is really limited, and I have to pay for the online, for the, you know, the online, the live, and everything like that. For PS3, I really, you know, I add anybody because I can just create multiple accounts, but I can't really do that for the Xbox because I have to pay for multiple accounts and everything like that. So I apologize to all you guys out there. If I have like room left, I guess, I don't know, I'd like hold a competition, I guess, to be on my friends list, because I don't believe in selling spots on your friends list. That's just ridiculous and retarded. I gotta admit, I did think about it, but the more I thought about it, the more I realized how retarded it is, because after all, I'm just a YouTuber. I'm no different from you guys that are watching my videos right now. And I don't think that it's right for me to just take advantage of my subscribers and, you know, charge you money just to be on my friends list. Because you know, some people do that, some people are okay with it, and if they do that, then that's fine. But you know, some people do it because they think like they're God or something like that. But at the end of the day, it's just YouTube, and it's not really that serious, you know what I'm saying? But I don't know what I'm gonna do for like the spots that I'm gonna open up to the public. Maybe a competition, maybe, I don't know, like a random ass drawing or something like that. I don't know. I'll have to figure it out. You guys, if you guys got any suggestions, that's what the comment section is for of this video. Just leave a comment. You know, leave 5 comments, leave 1,000 comments. Please don't do that. Seriously, I literally do read every comment, and I know some of you guys are like, I call bullshit on that, but I really do. I don't get like 1,000 comments a video, so it's possible, you know. Unless you can't read, then you have issues, my friend. But unless you're like 5 or 2 years old, then you know that's an excuse. But if you're like 14 and you still can't read, something wrong there. And if it's a medical issue, then that's fine. But if it's not, then yeah, you know what I'm saying. But anyways, I was gonna talk about something else as well. Oh, I am accepting video submissions for those of you guys who have been asking, because some of you guys have been on my website and seen this video submission page, and you've been wondering what the fuck is it about. But basically what it is, that sometimes I get really busy with school and life and a lot of things, and I don't have the time to record gameplay, and I might not have gameplay on my hard drive. So what I'll do is this: whenever I don't have gameplay, like I've been so busy, I'm just gonna go into the video submission page. I'm gonna download whatever video I feel is the best, and I'm gonna use that gameplay. Whoever's gameplay it is, I'm gonna use it as the video, and I will give you a shout out. I'll say that this is your gameplay. Check out your channel in the description box, and you know that'll be that. That'll be able to help you while you're helping me at the same time. So, you know, I scratch your back, you scratch mine. That kind of gay shit like that, or you know. I rub something, you... Nah, let me not even get into that. But, yeah, that is kind of gay, really. But, in order to do so, here's what you're going to have to do. This is the best way I find to do it. You basically just upload your video to YouTube, your gameplay to YouTube. Put it as unlisted. Don't put it as private. Put it as unlisted. And basically just link me to the unlisted video using the website in the description box. Fill out that form and put the link in the description, in the form. And don't delete the video until I post a comment saying downloaded. When you see me posting a comment saying downloaded, you know that I downloaded your video. Or I'll probably send you a message because I don't want to like fill up my recent activity with downloaded. But I'll send you a message saying that I downloaded your video, and then you could delete it after that. But remember that I know some of you guys are like, well, I don't want to keep a video up for that long. But, you know, YouTube is unlimited space, really. So you can do that, or you can upload it to a file hosting site, which I wouldn't recommend because they do take it down after a while. And, you know, I'm not God, and my connection definitely isn't God, so, you know, I can't download like 1,000 videos a day. So it might take some time for me to get to your video, but be patient. Patience is a virtue. Patience is a virtue. And I love the way Al Team stole their boat. I don't know how they did that because they can't go back there, but that's just weird. Vietnam, the expansion pack, I love it, and it's amazing. And a lot of times, you know, you run into good teammates, but then you got those times that you run into those teammates who just like sit and like snipe and think that, you know, if you're defending, that's good. If you're sniping, you know, you can keep the enemy back. But when you're attacking and you're just staying in one spot sniping, not actually overlooking the objectives and make sure your teammates are being you know, secured and watching their backs as they plant the objectives, then that creates an issue because you're not going out there and risking your ass for the team, and that's just ridiculous. Now you see how the team is all filled up now, so that's great. But the game is amazing. I would highly recommend it to any of you guys. I know I keep repeating this in like every Battlefield commentary, but I really want to see Battlefield get out there as much as Call of Duty has been getting out there recently, and that would be amazing to me. See the Battlefield community just grow extremely large, no homo intended, but that would be extremely amazing because I believe a lot of people out there will enjoy it, and they haven't even tried it yet because they just put it off. And a lot of people are just, you know, they're closed-minded when it comes to video games, and all they think about is Call of Duty, Call of Duty, Call of Duty. If it isn't like Call of Duty, then they don't give a shit about it. But you know, you got to be open-minded towards a lot of things, and you got to look at things in different perspectives. And Battlefield is a highly realistic game, and I do enjoy it very much, so I would highly recommend it to you. So the commentary is going to be over in like another 40 seconds. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Remember, the main highlights was just that Arc Gaming, go check them out. I got an Xbox, but the friends list is closed to the public for now, and I forgot the other shit. I really did forget the other shit. I think it's right here. It should be right here. Oh, video submissions. Check out that link in the description box. If you have a cool gameplay that you want to see uploaded to my channel, if I don't have the gameplay at the moment, then I'll use yours. You know, just go back in the video and listen to what I said. But I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, favorite, whatever you want with the video. Jerk off to it. I really don't care, but that was gay as well. Peace.